Yo, what's up? It's Yo Rumi. So I want to make a video about as an online marketplace in the earliest stages, how you can onboard your first users, optimize their user profiles, and then also how you can help them get started creating listings, optimize those listings, and have very high quality listings on your marketplace. So that way you can then in turn generate as much demand as possible. So I'm screen sharing you right now. This is just going to be like a kind of a screen share where I walk through a guide that I've actually created. So I've created like a multi-step guide, provided kind of email templates as examples that you can use. And hopefully this is helpful for you if you're in the earliest stages of building and launching an online marketplace. So just for a little bit of context, I am going to use Studio Time that I started as a real example. So I'm screen sharing right now the actual live site, and I'm just going to point out some specifics that I include in the guide and then why, and hopefully that'll provide a little bit of kind of context. But you can see right here, so here's our listings that we have live, some in New York City. So they have quite a few bookings. This one has 132, this one has 82. So these are listings that have been optimized by our team and also the user profiles. So over the course of a few years of doing this with Studio Time and also working with a lot of other marketplaces, I just kind of put together this guide so that way hopefully you can use it for your marketplace. So let's just jump right into this guide. So once again, this guide is for optimizing users that sign up for your marketplace. And then prompting them to create listings if they haven't already, and then optimizing those listings so that way you can have high quality listings available for bookings or transactions on your marketplace. I also want to mention that this is just kind of like a placeholder kind of steps that I've mapped out here. So of course there can be specific kind of use cases for your marketplace that might not fall within this kind of guide or framework that I created. So just want to mention that. Also too, typically this guide is used with a lot of share tribe based marketplaces. So if you have a B2B marketplace or any other kind of specific marketplace that isn't built on share tribe, you might want to kind of modify this for your specific kind of needs on the tech side and kind of on the ops side. So let's get into it. So the first thing to do when you see that a new user signs up on your marketplace is you can review their user profile. So as an admin or kind of operator of your marketplace, if you're in the earliest stages and you just built and kind of launched this yourself and you're a solo founder, of course, and this is going to be you, you're not going to have like a I would say like a user kind of onboarding or supply onboarding and acquisition kind of team yet. But using this guide will help you kind of create a process around it. Understand what works, what doesn't work, how to improve, and then you can create kind of your own process and framework. And then that way you can start to then, as your marketplace scales, you can kind of build a team around that. And this is what they can then use. So the first thing to do, of course, as I mentioned, is review the user profile, right? So as you do that, you can do that from your admin panel. So typically, if the user signs up and you can see that their profile isn't optimized. So for instance, we'll just go down here. So this is step one, right? So we see that this example is an optimized user profile. So what does that mean in the use case of Studio Time? That means that this person has their real name. They verify their contact information, which is part of kind of the initial user sign up process. They have a profile picture. So I'm just going to touch on a few of these points really quickly. But if you're an online marketplace for booking offline services, real user information and verification is very important. It helps build trust within the marketplace. And typically people want to see kind of who's behind the services or whatever transaction that they're requesting. So that way it helps just increase the trust of your marketplace and that there's a real person behind it. So that goes a long way. And also too, you see like a bio right here. Then also some links, for example. I wouldn't suggest making links probably not as prominent as we have them right here, because that way you don't want like any kind of slippage, people going off your platform. But we have links for reference right here on all of our user profiles. And then of course, the user profile, then you can see the listing right here that I kind of screenshot, and that is optimized. So assuming that you use this guide and it kind of works your marketplace, you'll have an optimized user profile and listing. And then with that, hopefully bookings and the reviews right here that you'll see. But I just wanted to create this as an example. So I'm also going to include a link to this guide, which is like a Google Doc, in the description to this post. So you can check it out. And then you'll see the link to it right here. But this is just an example of what an optimized kind of user profile has. So if, you know, best case scenario, a user has all this information, you know, realistically, they're probably not. So what do you do as an online marketplace, right? So what I suggest is here's sending them an email personally. So you can send them an email, you know, if using your email as the founder of the company, and you can even include in the subject line, you can put, you know, your user profile or, you know, thanks for joining. But just whatever that kind of subject is, I would stick to that same subject for the specific reason why you're messaging the user. So for instance, if you're consistently messaging users to optimize their profile, which is step one right here in the guide, I would suggest using that same subject for them all. So that way, when it makes it easy for you to track, when you're going through your inbox and you're seeing the sent, then that way you know that, hey, if you sent and those kind of subjects match, that was the original reason why you reached out to that user. And typically those conversations just follow like a thread within that user from that first kind of point of contact. So doing this not only helps you get an optimized user profile, but also creates a relationship with that user. And they see that, you know, you're taking the time to reach out to them as the marketplace founder, operator, team lead, or so forth, and trying to help them best kind of use your platform. So here's the kind of email template that I typically use for studio time. So it's like, hey, name. So we can say like, hey, Wayne. So it's like, first off, thanks for joining studio time. And we're excited to have you join us. So I've noticed that you created a user profile, but want to make sure it's optimized. And you can also get started adding your studio as a listing. Before you do, please be sure to add a picture of yourself and also a brief bio to your user profile. Our community of artists like to know who they're booking studios from and potentially working with. So this goes a long way and helps increase trust in our marketplace. Once that is completed, you can get started adding your listing here, and it's super easy and only takes a few minutes. If you need an example listing to check out what an optimized listing looks like, you can see this one. Please let me know if you need any help getting started, as we're here to help. So, and of course I put like Jill right here, which is Studio Time Concierge. So now we kind of have a team sometimes that we use as far as for onboarding, or we did as far as for supply kind of optimization. So that's why this name's right here. So you could of course use your founder name, but a few kind of key points within this, this is a very personal message. It also kind of shows or mentions what exactly they need to do, and then kind of prompts the next steps, which is once they do that, they can then add their listing, which is kind of what you eventually want to get as an optimized listing. And then also too is providing this example. So why that's very powerful is that if they click on this example, so we'll just click on this right here. So that's actually that person's profile that I was referencing. But if you're a new user that signs up to join Studio Time and you see this listing and it's optimized, then you kind of use this as a template and you say like, well, first off, there's like 16 reviews and there's like 82 bookings. Like clearly this platform kind of works and this is an optimized listing. So then you'll take the time to kind of model your listing after this with, you know, the hopes of the same kind of results, which is this many bookings or whatnot. So that's kind of a little bit more about this first kind of step. Now, step two, we'll kind of go back up here. So those are the templates below, but these are typically the steps. So step two is reference a user or studio and prompt to add listings that they haven't already, right? So step one was a user that signed up that you could see didn't have a user profile. And so they first off need to optimize user profile. And then from there, they need to add a listing, right? So step two is, what if they already have an optimized user profile? You can just skip that part. And then you just notice that they're a studio and they haven't added a listing. So what do you do? So step two is the email that you can send them. So it basically follows the same kind of format. And you can, of course, modify this for your specific kind of needs and the tone that you kind of use. But it's first off, thanks for joining Studio Time. We're excited to have you join us. I noticed that you've created a user profile, but you haven't had a chance to add your studio listing yet. You can get started adding your studio listing here, and super easy and only takes a few minutes. If you need an example listing, you can check out this optimized listing like this one on Studio Time here. Please let me know if you need any help getting started, as we're here to help. So that's just like a very short kind of prompt for them to get started adding their listing. And then once again, you provide the example. So that's step two. So hopefully they see that and then they get started adding their studio listing. Now, step three is going to be assuming that that user then added a listing, but it's probably not an optimized listing. So honestly, if you've started an online marketplace before, or you already have a few listings, you know that typically listings are not going to be optimized probably 99% of the time. So this is first off kind of why I created this video and this guide to help you then get the optimized listings. But this is kind of the key part right here, which is step three. So you're going to basically, step three is going to be, okay, that person created a listing, but maybe it just says like, you know, Studio New York City, it has a placeholder image and just a placeholder description, right? So, or it's just, you know, a little bit more thorough, but it's just not optimized, right? So here's the screenshot of what I shared previously, which is the Stand Up Sound New York listing. And that's a live listing, by the way. So a few points on that, as I mentioned, that I'm going to point out that are specific to studio time and how that listing is optimized. So the first is that the images are high resolution, and the control area of the studio is shown as a cover image. Now, early on in studio time, we started to notice a lot of different types of images that were used for the covers. And we really had to understand, you know, what kind of like looks the best and performs the best on the main kind of like card view, which is kind of like the main search results on studio time right here, right? So as you'll see, typically all of these are like the control area. So you can see this studio and then 727, I mean, pretty much them all, right? Here's an exception right here, the tiny cupboard. But typically we recommend that the control area is used as the cover. And that was just after kind of seeing, you know, our first kind of listings and then optimizing them with the studios. And then asking artists, you know, what were the most kind of compelling images and whatnot, and just really understanding what performs best. So that was just the first point. So now you'll see in this kind of email below, but we actually make the suggestion for that in case they didn't add the control area image as the cover. Now, we also don't allow any text. We don't allow any kind of watermarks or anything, you know, any graphics on the images. That just kind of takes away from really just showcasing the actual physical space and the studio on studio time. So then the next kind of point about an optimized listing is the detailed description. So in the description, this is kind of the same. So over the course of time, we just understood like what works the best on the listings as far as the information that artists need to know in order to pretty much book a music studio sight unseen through studio time. So that information is basically mentioning the studio space, the specific studio setup. So sometimes the spaces have multiple studios and multiple kind of setups, how it's typically used, what it's ideal for, and then any other specifics. So for instance, if the studio is ideal for mixing or mastering, and that's, you know, that's how it's typically used, and it's a plug and play kind of studio. So you can simply just kind of, you know, bring in your laptop, plug in, and, you know, you can start mixing. Well, if that's specifically what I'm looking for, that is a very specific listing, and that's going to then compel me to book that studio. Versus some others that are going to be a little bit more kind of like generalized listing and kind of like more multi-purpose. So then the next kind of part, which we, I would say we more recently added. So if you're a ShareTribe Go-based marketplace, you're not really going to be able to account for this, but is, so we have different specific service add-ons. So we're going to go back to the listing so you can see right here. So for instance, you can book a studio for a kind of the booking unit is per hour. We also have service add-ons. So we have to make sure that this is very clear in the listing, not only, you know, any kind of information around the hourly minimums or whatnot, but are there additional services that can be booked with the space? So that's kind of what we have right here. And typically in all this information, the description, you can see right here, they kind of show a little bit more about that. So we'll jump back over here to the listing guide or optimization guide. All right, so from there, then we have all the different booking details to keep in mind, all listing detail fields completed, studio rules, and then optimize user profile if they haven't done it above prior to creating their listing. So it's fairly straightforward. Basically what we do in summary is that we review all the different fields on these listings to make sure that the studio took the time to go through and optimize their listing. So as you can see right here, this studio did, and that's why I'm using it as an example, and it performs pretty well on studio time. They've had 82 bookings so far. So that's just an example of what an optimized listing has. And so if you use this guide for your marketplace, you can take the time to go through and, you know, optimize your first listing, even kind of create like a placeholder listing. And then that way you can kind of drop it in here and just use that as a guide for reference in the future. Now, you might be asking yourself, okay, what if a user has added a listing, but it's not optimized? Well, in that case, then you can send them an email such as this kind of template that we use right here. Now, it basically says, hey, name, you know, thanks for submitting your listing. And we just made your listing live, which you can see here, right? So you would include the link to their listing so that way they can check it out. And then you mentioned, we're checking out your listing now. And while the studio looks great, we have some suggestions for changes you'll need to make to your listing. Now these right here, so I mentioned, please use high resolution images that show the space, studio setup, and control area. And then I mentioned the higher quality images you have, the better, right? Same thing when I kind of go down and basically mention, please add a thorough description, and then also picture yourself in a brief bio, right? So this is fairly straightforward, but I do want to mention, so behind this template is actually kind of behind the scenes, actually reviewing that user's listing and making specific notes and using that kind of within this email. And then from there, it kind of the part beyond that is just wanting to send the above notes and suggestions so you can optimize your listing on studio time and generate as many booking requests as possible. Now, the reason why I mentioned that is because basically what it alludes to is that by taking the, you know, first off, we reviewed your listing and we're sending back specific suggestions. So that way you can get as much value and generate as much revenue out of our platform as possible. So basically it kind of alludes to, hey, if you take the time to optimize your listing, there's a high reward or potential reward, which is potentially a lot of booking requests through studio time. Also too, I mentioned right here that when the above are completed, you can tag us on social and we'll be sure to reshare all posts and whatnot. And then I do mention that studios love doing this as it helps build awareness, visibility, it can start driving booking requests. So that's also kind of build some excitement around after they do that is sharing it on social. So the reason why we do that is because it of course builds, you know, for us that's kind of amplifies our social presence. But also too, we actually do reshare these studios on our Instagram because they typically, you know, they typically do like a kind of like a video where they show, you know, their studio time listing and tag us in it. And they're super excited because people can now book their studio on studio time. And it's kind of also like a sign of credibility in the industry. So for us, then we kind of make a big deal about that and reshare it in our stories and let people know about a new studio. So that definitely goes a long way and has helped build our social presence. And it actually does drive booking requests, even from the swipe up sometime. So we do mention that right here. Now we're gonna go back up to the guide, right? So we've gone through step one, which is basically review user profiles that don't, you know, so someone just signed up checking out your marketplace, but they don't have their, you know, their profile picture, a bio. So they don't have a completed and optimized user profile. So we reviewed the email template that you can use to send to them. Now, number two was, you know, referencing a user that signed up that could or couldn't have an optimized user profile, but you've identified that they're a supplier or in our case, a music studio. And so when you know that, then you also know that they haven't created a listing yet. So how do you prompt them to then get started creating a listing? Now, step three was that user then kind of did create a listing, but it's not an optimized studio listing. So how do you then review the listing and communicate the changes that need to be made for that studio listing so that way they can have an optimized listing on your marketplace and generate as many booking requests and as much revenue as possible through your marketplace? Now, that following step, you know, those different steps, so step one, two, and three, at that point, you basically have what you need as an online marketplace. So you have an optimized user profile, you have an optimized listing, and you also have a relationship with your supply side, right? So at that point, then you have something that then you can is basically optimized for bookings or transactions on your marketplace. And not only that, but it's also an example that other suppliers or studios will reference when they come and they want to sign up and add their own studio. And hopefully that just helps kind of increase the quality of all of your listings on your marketplace and the supply. So we're not going to stop there. So we're actually going to go to step four, which is prompt social sharing and listings on social. So most likely, if you're in the earliest stages, you know, you won't have a lot of visibility on your social, but you'll probably understand, you know, what's the ideal social platform for you. and you want to kind of prompt sharing on that, right? So once we kind of alluded to it in step three, after that, if they haven't done that, which they probably won't, they'll probably send you an email back and say, hey, we made these changes, let us know what you think. And then from there, you can review it and you can say, hey, that looks great, right? And then from there, you can send a reminder to prompt them to share on social. Now you might be wondering, like, does that actually work? So in the case of studio time, it actually does. I'm gonna go down here and share the example kind of email template that we use. So step four, so email to users who have optimized their user profile and listings. So as I mentioned, whether they email you back and say, hey, we made these changes, or they made the changes and they didn't message you back, and you just kind of see it because you refreshed their listing, which you'll probably do if you're in the earliest stages of your marketplace, you can send them an email saying, hey, you know, hey, name, thanks for making the changes we suggested and your listing looks great, right? We'll be sure to recommend it to requests we get for anyone that is looking for a similar studio. Also, we mentioned social, but you can tag us on social. We're StudioTime.io. And then, of course, right here, I link to our Instagram. We'll be sure to reshare posts and stories. Studios love doing this as it helps build awareness, visibility, and can start driving booking requests. Some may even add their studio user profile or listing URL to the profiles, which, of course, we love seeing. Thanks, and we're here to help. So let us know if you need anything at any time, right? So this is actually a very powerful message because at first, you know, first off starts with like, hey, thanks for making the changes that we took the time to go through and suggest to you. And then you also basically say, hey, you know, you allude to, we're getting a lot of requests, so we'll be sure to make this recommendation for your studio. So it shows that you actually care and you're going to help them and suggest their studio to people that request that to you via support or, you know, word of mouth or whatnot. Also, too, you reiterate the part about social, and then you kind of throw in there the part about adding your studio time user profile or listing to their social profile. So a lot of studios on Instagram, if they're home studios or kind of, I would say, probably like mid-level studios, they might not, take the time to invest in creating their own website, and that just might not come off as professional compared to some of the top-line studios. So a lot of studios actually just simply use their studio time URL for their profile. If they have multiple listings or if they have one listing, then they just simply just include the URL for their listing in their social bio. And that's, it's definitely kind of come to the point where that is a sign of credibility for like home studios and mid-level studios. So then the last kind of part on that is just mentioning that you're here to help. So let us know if you need anything at any time. So a lot of I also want to just kind of make a point that, you know, this is definitely a manual process of step one through four, but these emails, they definitely not only, I would say can be used to help increase, you know, the quality of your user profiles and, you know, trust in your marketplace and the quality of the listings and just make sure all your listing or supply is optimized. They more importantly, or not more importantly, but equally as importantly, create a relationship with your users and your supply side. And it really goes a long way. And it just displays that, you know, you care deeply about, you know, what you're building and trying to help them get as much value out of your platform as possible. Because at the end of the day, they are taking a lot of time and kind of a leap of faith to join. And then you let them know that you're here to help at any point. So typically how these kind of emails have, you know, how we've seen this kind of play out long-term at studio time is this has created that relationship with the studios, and they do typically reply kind of in those threads if they need, you know, any help at any time. What that does is that then, you know, we're very responsive in that on the support side, and it makes sure everyone has the best experience possible on studio time. Because the more that your supply invests in your marketplace, the better experience that even the demand side or the artists are going to have when they do book the studio and they have a transaction through your marketplace in an offline experience. So hopefully this guide is helpful. The reason why I created this once again was, in the earliest days of studio time, we had a lot of users sign up. Their profiles were not, you know, optimized. We had a lot of listings. Those weren't optimized either. We really just, took the time to understand how do we optimize user profiles, kind of create more trust with our marketplace, optimize all the listings. What were some of the different kind of factors, you know, or specifics to the listings that, you know, we needed to suggest, and how do we suggest those so that way the listings could be optimized and seeing the actual results through the increase in bookings through our marketplace and the increase in trust. So hopefully you can kind of use this for your marketplace, especially if you're a ShareTribe Go or ShareTribe Flux marketplaces in the earliest stages. Also do want to mention that StudioTime currently is a subscription-based marketplace. So of course we have a few different steps within this because we do require a subscription. So, why I didn't include that in this is because most marketplaces don't require a subscription on the supply side, especially not in the earliest stages. So I wanted to make this as helpful and kind of applicable to as many marketplaces as possible. But if you have any questions about how you can use this and modify it for your specific marketplace, definitely just comment below because I try to read all the comments and make more videos based off what you want to, what you want to see next. And what might be helpful, but I'll also hit the thumbs up if you found it helpful and subscribe because it helps me, keeps me motivated to make these videos. I am going to mention that I am going to do another video after this that is a kind of guide on marketplace ops. So not just optimizing user profiles, prompting, listing creation and optimization, but more on the transaction side. So throughout every step of the process of your marketplace bookings or transactions, how can then you help provide kind of like an ops or support side to help make sure everyone has the best experience possible doing so? So expect another kind of like a, I guess, like screen share video kind of like this coming up soon. But I do have like a full guide for that. I do have email templates and I'll share some kind of, it'll be, using StudioTime as an example, and I'll share some kind of like a real, insights and learnings from that. So hopefully you can use it for your marketplace. Thanks.